What's Uncle Keith up to today? Well, Bluetooth, stereo. So, work truck. Jeremiah, remember when we drove that time and the stereo sounded awful and we could only listen to stations in between stations and it was really awful? The music sucked. Well, today we're going to change that out. So this guy's missing like a seek button and it only has a CD player, but nobody has any CDs anymore unless you bring along this really big thing. Yeah, whatever. All I want to do is be able to stream Bluetooth from my phone while I listen to stuff. It doesn't have to sound great, just something. And I don't want to spend a whole bunch of money on it. So for $39, I got this guy. So literally less than $40, and well, for $50 altogether, got this little, they didn't have this when I was a kid, I had to splice every wire in all single-handed and stuff. So for $50 we're gonna take this stereo and update it and have a Bluetooth stereo. That means that we can plug our devices in and listen to our own music. It's gonna be awesome. There's a cargo lamp button on. I don't know why that keeps coming on. Anyway, 200,000 mile truck, total stereo makeover for about $350. $300 on the speakers, $50 on the radio, and it's gonna be great. All right. Step one. We are going to need to get that radio out. So, pretty simple. There's a screw there, a screw there, and then screw, screw, screw behind these guys. All right, so we take all these three out, this one and this one, and this thing pops out. I'll show you in a minute. So in order to get this off, we need something to get in behind there and pry it out, and then something to pry it out better with so you don't kill it. So this guy in here, pry that out, pop this guy out. These are handy tools and they're not expensive, but if you're gonna have an older car, you're gonna want that. Look at there. Now we got these right here. These four gotta come off. That all this stereo stuff that Toyota did, and they made them all the same. So 10 millimeter. This guy comes out, you got these two little clips back here, and then all right, so this guy goes to your antenna, pretty small, and these guys go to your speakers and stuff, and so we don't have to look stuff up and figure it out. These guys will plug right into that and then hook right up to the back of the new stereo. Cool. Now I gotta find that nut in there somewhere. That screw in there. It went down in there. Oh, whatever. I'll find it, or I won't. That's okay. All right, well, I spent more time than I really want to admit trying to find where that screw went, and I'm just going to go ahead and say, whatever, I'll hear it rattling around and I'll just turn the stereo up and I won't be able to hear it anymore. So that's what we're gonna do with that. But now we have this as our new stereo. Look at how genius that is. That's beautiful. I'm hoping that's gonna work, because we've got two plugs in there,
one plug right there.
So we'll see what that does. But here's the old one. Look how big and heavy it is. Oh, so we probably won't need that extra screw to hold it in place anyway.
Oh gosh.
Yeah, so super heavy. But we got to take these guys right here. This is how it's mounted. So we got to take this guy and the other one off, and then those holes right there where they go. And this thing is so light. All right, well, we'll see what happens. Should be fun. Keep you posted. Soldering all these, matching these guys up. So you want a really strong connection right there. So that's nice and connected. Now, just gotta match all these up. Good to go. Well, I know what you're thinking. But Uncle Keith, you normally use those really cool marine butt connectors that you hit with a heat gun and it melts all the plastic around like a heat shrink tube thing, and you would be right, but unfortunately, you know, I've used all of them. I had some more somewhere, but I'm sure that there was a project I was doing, and well, now I don't know where they are, if I even have any more. So definitely have to order some of those. And then all I know what you're also saying is, but Uncle Keith, you got all that heat shrink tubing you could have done and soldered. I'm like, yeah, I would do that. But I'm just really not interested in that extra step today, because it is, again, a 200,000 mile truck that who knows how long it'll last. It's a farm truck. And I know, I normally do everything the best I possibly can. But, you know, sometimes you just gotta let it ride. So we're gonna use electrical tape. And then we're gonna go in there and plug everything up and make sure that it works. And if it doesn't work, we'll figure out what the problem is. And if it does work, well, then we can move on to step 967 billion. The brackets that came with the truck and the extra mounting special thing I bought to make it fit, none of those fit this stereo that I got for $39, which is probably why it was $39. So we'll probably use the drill press, the sanding, the electrical sander and stuff, and we're gonna make that bracket work. I need to get at least two screws, even if I only get, like, you know, two, that's all. But yeah, we'll figure it out. Anyway, I'm gonna finish this up and then we'll go in there and test it. We've got all these guys plugged in now, taped up. That guy, stereo. Moment of truth in this thing. Well, watch out. Is there power somewhere? Oh! What?
Oh, they're right there. Surely there's a scan. What? Oh, hey now. That sounds way better. That sounds way better. Mode. Nope, not pair.
All right. Real test here. I'm gonna leave you right there. Bluetooth. Bluetooth. Pair new device. Well, I'm packing up my cane and I'ma head out west, where real women come equipped with scripts and fake breasts. Find a nest in the hills, chill like Flint, buy an old drop top, find a spot to pimp. Then I'm a kid rocking up and down your block, but with a bottle of scotch and watch lots of crotch. I'm excited. This is awesome. So I'm obviously gonna have to cut some of this out because copyright, whatever, but thank you, Kid Rock. Okay, new plan. Make this template right here. It matches these holes. And then I'm gonna go get that thing over there. I'm gonna drill some holes in it. Maybe that'll work. Who knows? If it doesn't, no problem. Okay, so old stereos used to have these little holes to line these guys up. Apparently new ones do not. So this is my template when I wrote it, and looked like that, which obviously that doesn't work out so well. But when we take it around this side and line it up, well, this was going to be a problem anyway. But look right there, these guys right here are in the way. So, new addition to new plan. I'm going to take this guy, I'm going to get rid of that. That won't be dangerous at all. Not even kind of. Okay, maybe a little bit. Nope. Yep. Don't mind the dust. Look at that. Those things aren't in the way anymore. All right. So here we go. So this is the way it goes in. And that's the way I drew it. On top. So this goes here. That just seems, oh, there we go. That's much better. All right, so now, if we drill these holes like that, surely that'll work. And don't call me Shirley. There we go. Yeah, that's perfect. Lined right up. So, center. We need a center punch. All right, this is a center punch, which means I'll use it to find the center of the hole that I'm about to drill. Just push down on it and it clicks. All right. Cool. I just gotta drill holes that big. I just gotta clean that up. Good to go.
Well,
they make these things right here. I just gotta cut this piece off and then just kind of put a little sticky stuff on there and that'll help fill in that hole there. I could actually adjust my holes on my brackets and bring this out farther and put this guy on, but I don't want to do that. I don't really mind having that little bit of line there. Just like I said, I'll cut this guy off and fill that hole up a little bit with that. But yeah, all I gotta do now is put these screws back in. And yeah, I'll let you check it out.
Lord, it's the same old tune, fiddle and guitar. Where do we take it from here? Rhinestone suits and new shine.
Well, a little bit of an engine whine in there. I gotta figure out it's probably a ground or something that I need to, or could just be there's a bad filter on this $39 stereo, but the whole thing $350 ish. And once I put those little side pieces in, you won't even notice those little gaps there, but we got to play with all kinds of cool things. Screwdrivers, sanders, drills.